Hello, this video is one of a series showing you the best bits of Piranesi so you can use it more effectively. In this one, I'm going to show you how to create an anaglyph stereo image from this picture. In order to generate a good anaglyph image, you need to take a little care in setting up your file to start with. So the first thing I'm going to do is show you how I've structured the image in Piranesi into a number of layers so I'll be able to produce a better anaglyph. At the base, I have a layer just containing the ground as a horizontal plane and a sky background. In front of that, I've got the house as it was generated from the renderer into EPIX. And then in the next layer, I've painted textures over the top of the house. I normally do this so that I can preserve the shading. This layer has an overlay mode, so it preserves the lightness and darkness of the layer below it. On top of that, I have another layer in which I have created some railings along the front. These were created with the Construct tool using one of the standard styles provided with Piranesi. I also have a number of cutouts. One of them is actually part of the model that I separated out so that I'd get a better image and then brought it in as a floating cutout. On the Edit menu, there's a Make Stereo Image Pair command. I'm going to create a red cyan anaglyph that you can look at with red cyan glasses. If you've got yellow-blue glasses, you could use a yellow-blue anaglyph, or you can create separate layers and combine them for whatever viewing mechanism that you have. You get a choice of picking either an angle for the two views or a distance between the eyes. I'm going to go for 3 inches between the eyes, and I'm going to pick the door as a focus. Then I create the image. Piranesi is now calculating what the scene looks like from slightly to the left and right of the current eye point, and it's going to combine them. If I'd picked a wider separation between the eyes, I'd get a more pronounced stereo effect. If I'd picked a different distance for the focus, then things at that distance would be lined up very closely and they would be separated as you get further away. If we look down at the front of this image, you'll see that we have red and green sections here for the railings, which will be combined through the glasses. So that is how you can create an anaglyph using Piranesi. To find out more about Piranesi, please visit our website at piranesi.co.uk.